also for careers journeys toward the digital transformation?
So I think it varies from market to market and from really continent to continent. If we look at, let's say, developing markets, such as some local markets here in South America, a lot of the carriers outside of, let's say, Telefonica and América Móvil and Millicom have not yet started even the digital transformation journey, whereas some of the bigger group companies, such as Telefonica and Vodafone, are a lot of them are some way well into that transformation. And some of them are encountering problems and challenges, and others are already seeing the results. And I think that those carriers that have a strategic plan in place are following that plan and developing, you know, things like MVP, where they get value in short steps and tangible steps, are the ones that will succeed. Where OpenNet are helping is, let's say, the tier two and tier three carriers, where we're setting out a blueprint for the transformation in terms of technology, in terms of the strategy, in terms of the focus points, right the way through from start to finish. And we're helping a lot with the likes of 2degrees New Zealand and in Singtel in Singapore.
In your opinion, what are the key transformation brought to carriers through the digital? I mean, they were going to be ready to do some network analytics and to improve their customer experience. So what are the key benefits from them?
So I think there's three main benefits. If you look at the global digital transformation projects going on right now, I think they can be summarized in terms of the customer experience. So improving the customer experience, improving how you sell to a customer, how you acquire the customer, how you serve the customer. We call this new phenomenon the segment of one. So the customer feels like it's all about them. And digital transformation is a key enabler of that. The second piece is costs. So driving costs out of businesses. So digital transformation is doing that by way of automating a lot of the back-end processes that are today essentially a lot of teams of people doing manual processes to support the front end and the sale, acquire, service part of telco businesses. What digital transformation will do using analytics, using machine learning, is automate a lot of that. And the third area, I guess, is new businesses, new partners. So what digital transformation is doing is opening up new ecosystems. So to make it easy for third parties, digital companies to come in and sell their services to the end customer via the telecommunications company. And that's the three, I think, main business drivers to this digital transformation phenomenon that we're seeing.
Is digital transformation key for the 5G?
Well, I think there's two key areas for 5G within digital transformation. The first one would be what I talked about already, analytics and machine learning. So 5G will mean a lot more data, much more than 3G or 4G. So it's important that operators put that data to use. And they can do that. So when we talk about customer experience and cutting costs, that's how digital transformation will enable that, because 5G will bring that challenge. I think the second part, again, I spoke about is the open ecosystem via open APIs to enable digital partners come in, integrate to companies easily, and sell their services.
Talking about MVNO, do you think we still have room for them to grow?
So I think MVNOs, I think there's still a place for MVNOs in certain markets. You know, a big driver for MVNOs is obviously regulation, and I think in certain markets regulation is supportive of MVNOs. It's instructing the operators to open up their networks to give access to new entrants, and that's driving competition, and that's only good for customers. But in other markets it's still not there and it's still catching up. So, you know, the customer, I think, is really the main driver here. So it's important that regulators realize that, and that, you know, open regulation is good for competition. So MVNOs are one part of that. And what that means is that, let's say, in the Brazilian market, it's important that companies with existing customer base, such as the groceries, the shopping centers, that they can start to offer mobile services as well. And ultimately, that's good for the customer.
Do you think digital transformation can be an enabler for MVNO, or it doesn't help at all?
So I think it is, absolutely. I think in terms of an enabler for MVNO, one subset, let's say, of the MVNO market is second brands, or digital brands. And that's all about selling and supporting the customer in a digital-only way. In some cases, like Telefonica Second Brand 20, all the services is provided by an app. So I think digital transformation with a BSS IT stack at the core is key for driving that business capability so that companies like Telefonica can offer a sub-segment of their customer base services that they want.
So it's much more from the customer experience point of view.
Exactly. Ultimately, it's the customer that drives these new businesses, these new services. And, you know, a lot of what we're seeing is markets are very broad in what the customers are wanting. So we have within the B2C market, you'll have probably 6 or 7 different segments within that. What we're seeing is the second brand is generally focused on a youth segment. So what we typically see is 16 to 24-year-olds. They generally want everything online. They consume everything online. They go online to top up, to recharge their cell. They look at their account management online. Generally, they don't like speaking to a person. So that's where I think operators can separate that and focus and ring fence those services within their business with a specialized value proposition. And in OpenNet, what we're doing is building a ring fence proposition in the cloud that enables operators to build their service as a service focused on a segment such as digital second brands.